If the witches were burned, was it a sort of a favor to them? A sort of a favor. The thing is that prior to burning them, it was always demanded that they renounce their power. If they did not renounce, then it could have been a favor, sure, but the renunciation did in fact take place. It was a fixed requirement. They wouldn't have been taken to the bonfire without it. First, they were tortured. And if they did not die from being tortured, they were pressured to renounce. And only after renouncing were they taken to be burned at the stake. They were natural witches who weren't even aware of what sort of force they worked with. Think common witch ladies. They did some sort of healing, whispering practices. They were not professionals. They were not truly knowledgeable. And their words were always perceived as they were. There wasn't any doubt that if they were renouncing, they are renouncing forever. Professional witches, actual Magi, however, if they happened to find themselves in this difficult situation, yes, they could have gone with this sort of trick in order to be burned. If, of course, they had enough strength and will left in them. Because if the common witch ladies were just tortured to death and forced to renounce, thereby severing their natural connection to the ancient goddesses in the earth, the true sorcerers and witches, on the other hand, were pumped for information by the Inquisition, before all their knowledge and rituals were extracted out of them and written down on paper, no one would commit them to death. They were even fed, and were not tortured. Comrade Torquemada put together such a wonderful collection of all sorts of ancient knowledge this way, that afterwards, there was not even the need for renunciation. Sometimes they weren't even executed. They just sent them to a monastery dressed in a San Benito and off you go. Generally, they executed natural witches who had a natural connection with the earth. This had its own reasons, and I speak about it during our course called The General Theory of Magic. I will not take the time to talk about it right now, but it had its own reasons. There is no need to kill a source of knowledge. All the knowledge must be extracted first. The Inquisitors knew that very well. They followed specific instructions. First, the brain must be emptied out dry. Then, do whatever you like with her. This is how it happened that the Vatican is now filled with this type of knowledge. And the more magical knowledge a newly formed religion possesses, the stronger it will be.